Ladies and gentlemen, the American Slovenian Polka Foundation proudly presents Award Show 7 and the 1994 inductees into the National Cleveland Style Polka Hall of Fame. And now, ladies and gentlemen, the Honorable David M. Lynch, the mayor of the city of Euclid. Oh, welcome to Euclid, Ohio. Welcome to this yearly treat. This place is the home of the polka, the music with that great ethnic beat. We hope you enjoy this performance. Listen to music we know to honor the people enshrined here on this year's polka show.
Thank you, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to the 7th Annual Polka Awards presentation. You know, it seems like just yesterday that we were in the basement of the St. Joseph's High School Gymnasium, and Tony Petkovic was sitting there talking about the idea of a Polka Foundation Museum and Awards presentation, and they wanted to find a location. And I will tell you that as mayor of the city of Euclid, I'm so proud that we had the opportunity to serve as the host community. At this time, I'd like to present, thank you. I'd like to present a gentleman who is a trustee of the foundation and a man whose name has been synonymous with polkas and outstanding radio presentations. The master of ceremonies for today's program, Mr. Ray Samich.
Welcome once again to our 7th Annual Awards Show. It is truly my honor to be back with you again for the 4th year, and I am looking forward to a great program, and I know that you are too. We have people with us today from around Greater Cleveland and Northeast Ohio, representing over 20 states of our great country, and many of our Canadian friends are with us. Welcome to each and every one of you. Our first presentation today is a very important award. It's the Cultural Heritage presentation. And we're going to find out who the winner of this is, but I've got to get some luck here first and introduce to you the man who's going to be bringing us the sealed envelopes, Mr. Al Favora, a partner of Arthur Anderson Company. All signed, sealed, delivered?
Ready to go.
And you're still playing polka music?
Sure.
Okay, Al, thank you very much. Mr. Al Favora. Now we're ready to get underway with that Cultural Heritage Award. And our first presenter is someone who has not forgotten where her culture and her heritage come from. She has gone on, as a matter of fact, if you are a listener of the AP radio networks, she is an anchor out of Washington, D.C. for the news reports. Also a very important person with their AP news radio. But her roots and her heritage comes right here, from Euclid, Ohio. As a matter of fact, her first job in radio was at WELW Radio in Willoughby. She also doesn't forget her roots with her parents, Jim and Vicki Kozel. Please welcome back to Cleveland, where she loves to come to be with all of us at Polka Time, Ms. Sandy Kozel. Welcome.
Thank you very much, Ray, and thank you, and thank everybody for letting me be here. I'm so honored to be a part of this. It really is very special to me. You know, I live and work in Washington, D.C., and symbols of our nation's heritage are all over. The Washington Monument, the Lincoln Memorial, the White House, and it's easy. That heritage kind of hits you in the face. It's right there. It's all over the place. But this kind of effort, I don't think, is quite as easy, because people really have to go out of their way to carry on these traditions, to be able to pass on the cultural traditions and knowledge from the past and from other places. And people do it because it's very special to them. And the people who are honored today are all very special, and they all deserve your applause. The nominees for the Cultural Heritage Award are Yadran Singing Society, Joe Valencik, the Slovenian Heritage Association of Pennsylvania, Marie Pivik, Eddie Kinnick, that is Eddie Kinnick, the Zadia Singing Society, and the Western Pennsylvania Cultural Group. And the winner is? The winner of the National Cleveland Style Polka Hall of Fame 1994 Annual Award for Achievement, Cultural Heritage, Eddie Kinnick.
Thank you so much. I can't say no more.
Maybe Eddie couldn't say any more right now, but his years and years of commitment to all of us has certainly said a lot already. Our next award is for support and promotion. And again, very important, each and every one of these awards is so very important to our cause, to let people know about the exciting things that we're doing and the exciting and proud events that we are performing in. Last year, WELW was the winner of the Support and Promotion Award. Thank you very much for that again. I would like to have to introduce you at this time to two of the members of the WELW staff to present this year's Support and Promotion Award. We have a gentleman who has not only excelled at WELW, but he's also gone on to proudly represent us by being the field voice of the Cleveland Indians at Jacobs Field. Also, we have with him our station manager at WELW. Please welcome at this time Mr. Mark Tromba and Ms. Camilla DeAndre.
Well, thank you very much, and Camilla, it's very nice to be here, obviously, and I must say, though, more nervous today than I was at any time broadcasting in front of 42,000 fans at Jacobs Field.
You know, I know what you mean, Mark, and I must say that I noticed something backstage. We're the only two people in today's entire program whose last names end in the letter A.
So why do you suppose they brought us here? Could they need free Indians tickets?
They're on strike. You should know that, I thought. Okay. And I'm sure all of these people would rather be attending a polka dance. You know? Yep, gives me an idea. And the nominees for the annual support and promotion award are...
Leading off, the second baseman, number 9, Carlos Baerga.
I think you got that wrong.
Wrong lineup.
Let's try that again.
Wrong lineup. First nominee, leading off, Gary Ramey. Bill Rendell. Bishop Edward Pevick. Dennis Bukar. George Knaus. And Tony Petkosic.
May I have the envelope, please? Never was quick in opening these things. And the winner is...
Ladies and gentlemen, may I have your attention, please? The winner of the Support and Promotion Award, Mr. Tony Petkovic.
You talk about support and promotion, and I have to turn the tables a little bit and just say I have been blessed for 33 years with all of the tremendous support from all of you beautiful people in the polka and nationality music field. And I mean that sincerely, so I want you to give yourselves a round of applause, okay? I also... On that roster of nominees, am a personal friend of every individual on there, and they all deserve the support from you, and I know you'll give it to them continuously in the future. All of them. I mean that sincerely. I think it's important that we realize the polka music needs more and more younger faces and younger influence. And that is why I wanted Joey Tomczyk to come up and also accept this with me, because Joe does a great job on the bandstand, on the radio, and also with polka tours. Thank you very much.
Congratulations to Tony, and if you're wondering, Tony's been having a great time the last couple of days promoting and supporting, and unfortunately, some of the vocal cords aren't working like they should be, but 33 years strong, I'm sure he's got many, many more good years left in those cords, and they'll come back strong, hopefully later today for his other presentations that he's involved with. Congratulations to Tony and Joey and everybody, also the nominees that were involved. Please keep trying. Please keep promoting our great polka music and our polka heritage. Last year, we introduced a new category, and we honored the greatest all-time hits in polkas and waltzes. We thought it was a great idea, and we know that our members also agree, because we've gotten a great response in terms of recommendations for songs to be chosen. At this time, we're going to present our greatest all-time waltz hit for our seventh show. And to do it, We have one of our trustees, as a matter of fact, he has been a trustee since the inception of our foundation. He also is our official historian, very much involved in the ethnic communities, starting when he was young with the SNPJ Circle 2 Junior Chorus, and continuing today, where he still serves as president of the SNPJ Cleveland Federation and on the board of other organizations. He also works around the community, and Mayor White has recently asked him to serve on the Cleveland Bicentennial Commission, where he will work in promoting our greater Cleveland heritage. Please welcome at this time to present our greatest all-time waltz hit, our own trustee, Mr. Joe Valencik.
If you recognize it, that's called Joey's Polka, and that's the only polka I ever wrote. I wrote it for my sister Silka when she was doing an album for the Almars, and I was 11 years old at the time. So that's, don't applaud. I mean, my polka career peaked at 11, so. By the way, the Vandals also picked up Joey's Polka for their dance repertoire, but it doesn't compare to one of the Vandals' more recent classics, My Alice Waltz. My Alice became an instant hit for Johnny upon its release in 1982 and has remained among the most popular Cleveland-style waltzes ever since. The musical ideas for My Alice were conceived by Johnny in the 1970s during a brief retirement in Florida. When he returned to Cleveland in the polka business in 1978, he started to orchestrate the song in informal sessions at Joey Miskelin's lounge. When Joey first heard the tune, he told Johnny to keep it under wraps until it could be recorded, lest it be picked up by a lesser talent. Joey's keen musical ear caught the expressive themes of My Alice, graced with Johnny's charming lilt and signature style. Joey knew a timeless melody when he heard it. In the definitive Vandal version, Johnny's plaintive accordion receives a wistful response from Norm Cobalt's saxophone. Frank Vandal's guitar, another unmistakable Vandal hallmark, sets the pace. The public immediately responded to My Alice with their feet. After all, who can resist a classic waltz? Dedicated to his wife, Alice, Johnny first released My Alice Waltz on a 45, followed by placement on his 50 Years of Memories LP. Gary Siebert, Eddie Roddick, and Barbara and the Carousels also recorded it. Grammy winner and Hall of Famer Walter Ostonek featured My Alice on Volume 1 of Polkastalgia and his polka video, Canada's Polka King. One of the most requested Cleveland-style songs, My Alice is essential to the repertoires of every band. Of course, all other versions pale to Johnny's original. So here's an unforgettable tribute to his Alice. Ladies and gentlemen, My Alice Waltz, performed by Johnny Vandal and Norm Cobalt.
Thank you.
Mr. Johnny Vadnal, and a beautiful arrangement. Even if you have never been to Slovenia, when you hear the middle of that song, you can kind of picture what it must be over there. Just, you can see why that certainly is the latest of our all-time greatest hits. Beautifully done here today. Gene Fedorchak is another one of our polka promoters. He also is a polka band member, musician, radio personality, having been on radio WKBN for over 10 years for his Sunday morning polka program. And we had originally thought he would be with us personally because he has always been a major